Hey guys, welcome to your general reading, what you need to know for Taurus. This is going to be for June 2022. You could apply this to any of your placements, even your nodes. So we're going to take a look at what's currently going on with you guys, what you guys need to know for the month, and then we will finish off the read to see what else you need to know for the rest of June and onward. So this could be in anything, nothing specific. So we're just going to see what the cards have to say. Apply this to your own unique situation. Keep in mind that these are general messages, so just take what resonates and leave the rest behind. If this message didn't resonate with you, take a look at your other, take a look at your other placements. If you guys haven't done so yet, hit the subscription button and the notification bell so that you guys get notified on when my new videos post. Give this video a thumbs up, like this video, share this video, leave a comment down in the comment section below if this message resonates. Keep in mind that these are collective messages for the collective Taurus people, not tapping into one specific person's energies in particular. So if you're looking for a reading that's tailored to your own unique situations, to your energies, I suggest you book a private personal reading with me. The link for that is in the description box below. Also, a quick note that this reading, these messages are not really meant to be cross-watched. The roles are not really meant to be flipped or reversed. This is more so for Taurus's personal growth and spiritual growth. But if you want to do that, you can feel free to do so, okay? So Taurus, let's get started. What is surrounding Taurus? What does Taurus need to know for June 2022? What does Taurus need to know for June 2022? What does Taurus need to know for June 2022? What do we have for Taurus here? What is surrounding Taurus? What does Taurus need to know for June 2022? What does Taurus need to know for June 2022? Three of Cups. Okay. Seems like celebration, having a good time. We have the Five of Cups. Oh, interesting. I feel like there are issues surrounding your friend group here, and I feel like these friend groups keep letting you down. This is a huge theme, because I've been doing these all day, and I feel like this is coming up for every single sign, okay? Let's see what else we have here. We have the Ten of Wands. We have the Page of Cups. So I feel like, Taurus, I feel like regarding your friends and your family or something like that, I feel like you've tried over and over and over and over again to get your point across to these people, and I feel like they're not getting it. Yeah, I just feel like you're at your wit's end. You're ready to, like, let this go or let these people go. Page of Cups, Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces. I feel like, you know, I feel like you might feel like they're very immature or emotionally immature, okay? Or just lack self-awareness. Four of Pentacles and the Four of Swords. Yeah, I just feel like you're no longer holding on to this, or no longer holding on to these people, or no longer holding on to the idea that these individuals will understand you. And I feel like you're completely disengaging and letting these people go. Eight of Pentacles on the bottom of the deck. Yeah, perhaps you're just gonna go off and just focus on yourself, focus on your work here, or focus on your craft. Perhaps you guys do artwork. Maybe that's how you guys make money. Three of Cups. Why is it Three of Cups here? Why is it Three of Cups here? Tell me about the Three of Cups. Why is the Three of Cups here? 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 Alright, Three of Cups. Eight of Wands. Okay. Five of Cups, and we have the Nine of Pentacles. I'm getting energy of, like, you know what? I'm just better off on my own. I don't want to deal with anyone. I'm just going to let them know and just go on my merry way here. Virgo energy, pre-Empress energy with that Nine of Pentacles, the Ten of Wands, and the King of Pentacles right here. We have that King of Pentacles on the bottom of the deck there. Page of Cups. With the Eight of Cups, yeah, I just feel like you're walking away. You're walking away. You're really, yeah. I just feel like you're just going off your merry way. I just feel like you're just not really dealing with a bunch of BS here. The Four of Pentacles, with the Hermit, yeah, you're gonna do some soul searching. You're gonna introspect, self reflect here, and really, just, it's about letting go here. And I feel like, you know, there are some Taurus, it really depends though, but some Taurus has a hard time letting things go. Yeah. It's a fixed energy, so it takes a longer time for it to happen for some Taurus here. The Four of Swords and the Ace of Wands. Again, it just seems like you're starting all over again. Perhaps you're focusing on your passions here, you're focusing on new ideas, you're focusing on business here, or focusing on starting a business. There could be a soulmate that's coming towards you. Yeah, we have the King of Cups and the Queen of Cups here. So if you guys are single, there could be a soulmate coming in towards you and wanting to build a relationship that you envision, that you want here, or that both of you guys are on the same page and you guys want the same things. Let's see what else we have here. What else does Taurus need to know? What else does Taurus need to know for the rest of June? What else does Taurus need to know for the rest of June and onward? What else does Taurus need to know for the rest of June and onward? We have the Five of Pentacles and the Emperor, Aries energy. Let's see what else we have here. We have the Queen of Swords and the Ten of Pentacles. Okay. Seems like there's a relationship being taken to the next level here. Yeah. Or that, you know, if you're single by yourself, you guys are business owners, and that, let's say you guys are planning on starting a business and you guys do start this business, it's going to be really prosperous. Yeah. Okay. With a Three of Swords and a Two of Cups. Okay. So if you guys are currently in the relationship, you guys could be separating from someone, or that you have separated from someone already. Six of Swords, yeah, there's the energy of definitely moving on, going your merry way, leaving the disaster behind here. Let's see what else we have. Five of Pentacles. Tell me about the Five of Pentacles. Why is the Five of Pentacles here? Tell me about this Five of Pentacles. Why is the Five of Pentacles here? Five of Pentacles. We have the Sun, Leo energy, the Emperor, Six of Swords. Yeah, you're like I said, I feel like you're just going off your merry way here. Yeah, it just seems like you're leaving a ton of stuff behind. Queen of Swords, Ten of Pentacles again. Yeah, so you're going your merry way and seems like prosperity is coming towards you here. Ten of Pentacles. Five of Cups. And the Five of Cups again. Seems like you're getting over the disappointment and the regrets here. And it just seems like things are gonna start getting better for you. Let's see. Tell me about the Three of Swords. We have the Seven of Cups, the Two of Cups, and the Nine of Cups here. There's a ton of endings that are happening here. So I do feel like you might be separating from someone that's kept you as an option here, okay? And like I said, I feel like Taurus, right now at the moment, you're realizing that you're better off alone than having to deal with all this. Seven of Cups and the Nine of Cups. Like I said, I feel like you're just going off your merry way and prosperity is coming towards you. We have the Ten of Pentacles here two times. It can't get any better than that. Okay, so Taurus, I hope that this was helpful. I hope that this resonated. If it did, leave a comment down in the comment section below. Share this video, like this video if you haven't done so yet. Subscribe, hit the notification bell, and I will speak to you guys in the next one. Thanks, guys. Bye.